Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Scheme Tutorials Hub. This is another video of the DBMS lecture series. In the previous two videos, I have discussed about the functional dependency, the closure of an attribute set, and equivalence of functional dependency. So if you have not yet watched those videos, then please go through them before watching this video. This will definitely give you a better understanding. In our today's video, I will discuss about the canonical cover of a functional dependency set. So let's begin our today's lecture without any further delay. Let's begin with the definition of a canonical cover or irreducible set. A canonical cover for a set of functional dependencies, say F, is another set of functional dependencies, say FC, such that all the functional dependencies in F logically imply all the functional dependencies in FC and vice versa. So for canonical cover, you must remember the following points. That is, F should logically imply all FDs in FC. That is, F must be equal to FC. Again, FC should logically imply all the FDs in F. The next point is, functional dependencies of FC should not contain any extraneous attribute. So what is extraneous attribute? Extraneous attribute is any such attribute which, if we remove from the functional dependencies, then the closure set of different attributes within the set of functional dependencies remains unchanged. And our last point is, the left hand side of all the functional dependencies in FC should be unique. Now, the algorithm for finding the canonical cover. So there are four simple steps following which you can easily find the canonical cover. Our first step is to apply the decomposition rule on the right hand side of each FD of the given FD set. Now, step number 2, find the closure of the left hand side of each of the given FD by including that FD and excluding that FD. So this will help us to find out which are the essential FDs among all the FDs in the given FD set. Now, step number 3, if the left hand side of any of the resultant FDs has two or more attributes, then we need to check the importance of each of those attributes. And finally, step number 4, you can apply union rule on the FD set if applicable. Let's work out an example so that we can understand the algorithm in a better way. So in the example, we have been given a relation R with attribute set P, Q, R, S. A set of FDs have been given, that is F, and we have to find the canonical cover of F. Our first step was to apply decomposition rule on the right hand side of each of the FDs. Our first FD is from X to W. So W is a single attribute, so as a result, this functional dependency will remain as it is. Now, the second functional dependency is from WZ to XY. So here we can decompose the functional dependency into two functional dependencies, that is from WZ to X and from WZ to Y. The third functional dependency is from Y to WXZ. So here we can decompose the functional dependency into three functional dependencies, that is from Y to W, Y to X, and from Y to Z. Our second step is to find the closure of the left hand side of each of the resultant FDs once by including the functional dependency and second time by excluding the functional dependency. Let's consider the first functional dependency, that is from X to W. Now, if we include this functional dependency, then the closure set of X will include X and W. And if we exclude this functional dependency, then the closure set of X will contain only X. So, as the closure set of X is changing on inclusion and exclusion of the functional dependency, so we cannot remove this functional dependency. This functional dependency is an essential one. Now let's move on to our next functional dependency, that is from WZ to X. So when we include this functional dependency, then the closure set of WZ will contain W, Z, X and Y. Now if we remove this functional dependency, then what will be the closure set of WZ? It will contain W, Z, Y and X. So this remains unchanged. So you can understand that this functional dependency WZ to X is non-essential. Now the third functional dependency, that is from WZ to Y. If we remove this functional dependency, then the closure set of WZ will contain only W and Z. So you can see, for this functional dependency, the closure set of WZ is changing. So we cannot remove this functional dependency. This functional dependency, that is from WZ to Y, is an essential one. Now our next functional dependency is from Y to W. So when we include this functional dependency, then the closure set of Y will contain Y, W, X and Z. And now if we remove this functional dependency, then also the closure set remains the same. That is, it contains Y, X, Z, W. So we can say that this functional dependency, that is from Y to W, is non-essential. Now the next functional dependency is from Y to X. If we exclude this functional dependency, then the closure set of Y will contain only Y and Z. So it is differing from the original closure of Y. So we cannot remove this functional dependency. This functional dependency is essential. Now our last functional dependency, that is from Y to Z. On removing this functional dependency, the closure set of Y becomes Y, X and W. So this is also differing from the original closure of Y. So we cannot remove this functional dependency. This is also an essential one. Here you can see that I have marked all the essential and non-essential functional dependencies by using tick marks and cross marks respectively. Now let's move on to our step number 3. So what was our step number 3? It said that if any of the resultant FDs contain more than one attribute on its left hand side, then we have to check the importance of each of those attributes. You can see that here I have written down all the functional dependencies after step number 2. So you can see that only the second functional dependency contains two attributes on its left hand side. For this functional dependency, we have to check the importance of the two attributes W and Z. For that, at first we will find out the closure set of WZ and then we will find the closure set of W and Z individually. If only W or only Z is capable enough to give all those attributes which are given by WZ, then only W or only Z will be enough and we will not require the two attributes W and Z. A single attribute will do the job. But here you can see that the closure set of WZ contains WZ, Y, X, whereas only W gives us a single attribute W, and the closure set of Z also contains only a single attribute, that is Z. So only W or only Z does not have the enough power to take the place of WZ. So here we have to keep the two attributes WZ in the functional dependency. As a result, the set of functional dependencies in step number 3 remains as it is. There is no change. Next, we move on to step number 4. In step number 4, we can use the union rule if applicable. So you can see among the 4 resultant FDs, the last 2 functional dependencies are from y to x and from y to z. So here we can apply the union rule on the right hand side. So the resultant set of FDs will be x to w, wz to y, and y to xz. This is our final set of FDs, and this is the canonical cover of F. Next is example number 2. Here we are given a relation R with attribute set v, w, x, y, and z, and a set of functional dependencies has been given, and we have to find out the canonical cover of this set. If you have understood the previous example, then you will definitely be able to solve this one. So try to solve this example by yourself and let me know the solution in the comment section. So that's all for today. I hope you have liked our today's video. If you do like it, then please hit the like button. You can always reach out to me in the comment section if you have any query. Please do subscribe to our channel if you have not yet done it, and also press the bell icon for getting the latest updates.